Jackson Hole is synonymous with all that is wild and untamed in the heart of the North American West, an unforgiving environment that is at once breathtaking and boundless. Our mountains are home to glory and adventure, and the generations of trailblazers who have made their pilgrimage to a place that has no equal. This is the story of Jackson Hole. The mountain at Jackson Hole has and always will be the hero in this valley. With 4,000 feet of continuous fall line skiing and panoramic views that span entire valleys, Rendezvous Mountain is an epicenter to adventure without equal.
Jackson Hole Mountain Resort, to me, it has always been about the mountain. We have couloirs, we have wide open glades, we have beautiful groomers. It's like Jackson Hole itself has a lifetime of skiing.
Welcome to the deep end of the pool. Anyone who has ever edged their tips into the gaping maw of Corbet's Couloir knows the feeling. Framed by towering limestone cliffs, North America's most infamous ski run has been a test piece for thrill-seeking adventurers for the last five decades. First eyed by Teton Mountaineer Barry Corbet, and later pioneered with the first descent by patrolman Lonnie Ball, Corbet's Couloir has been the venue for thousands of proud skiers vying for a piece of winter's glory.
When you're at the bottom of Corbett's and you look up, it doesn't look too bad. But then as you ski up to it from the top, it almost makes your stomach tingle.
You know, Corbett's has its historical relevance to the resort. I mean, it's a staple. It's kind of the mascot. It's one of those, you know, perfect shoots that just takes enough skill and mental determination to get into it. Like, you have to kind of give something up to drop into it. And that's the beauty of Corbett's. And I cannot imagine what it was like jumping in with equipment 20, 30, 40 years ago. Those guys are badasses.
Wild thing, I think you move me. But I wanna know for sure. So come on and hold me tight. You move me.
Quietly crouched beyond side of Corbett's is S&S Couloir.
Sands and Sims, Charlie Sands, a ski patrolman, and John Sims, a ski patrolman, they were the first to go in, and they won't tell who was actually first.
Skiers plummet 20 feet or more before banking a hard turn into the larger Corbett's runout. With a landing zone the size of a postage stamp, few people look into it, and far less past the point of no return.
S&S Couloir, you know, it's the bigger redheaded stepchild of Corbett's.
For many, skiing Corbett's or S&S is a graduation into the upper echelons of skiing. In truth, they're steps along the way to a greater journey. In 1999, JHMR partnered with the Bridger-Teton National Forest to grant access to the backcountry surrounding their resort. The move tripled the amount of lift service terrain and allowed skiers and snowboarders to rise 4,000 vertical feet and experience a new adventure every time they left the tram dock. Like Jackson's world-class inbounds runs, these challenging bowls, cliffs, and alpine cirques offered an exponential extension to Jackson Hole skiing.
The tram, you know, and the open gate policy, it's incredible the amount of access. So you could continue to explore. I mean, I've been here almost 20 years now, and, you know, I still get that excitement of discovery going out those gates and looking around, and, you know, it's really this kind of endless opportunity to go grow as a rider and explore and really enjoy, you know, the mountains.
Once the boundaries opened, you'd start going here and then going further and further, and it kind of ties back into who we are as skiers and people of Jackson. We always want to explore, we always want to check out that next spot, and having that out-of-bounds access is truly incredible.